Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Fran Nick Memorial Field on the beautiful campus of Holy Ghost Prep for today's game featuring Neshaminy High School and your Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds. As a reminder, Holy Ghost Prep promotes good sporting behavior by student athletes, coaches, and spectators, and requests your cooperation by supporting the Firebirds, opponents, and officials in a positive manner. Any profanity, racial, sexist, or other abusive comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal. Our starting lineups for today's contest, first for the visitors of Neshaminy High School. On attack, number 6, Pat Courtney. On attack, number 20, Lucas Mayer. On attack, number 13, Liam Ames. At midfield, number 3, Liam Moss. At midfield, number 15, Ethan Rooney. At midfield, number 9, Aiden Demi. On defense, number 12, Bobby Blum. On defense, number 21, Tim Trapp. On defense, number 11, Tim Ansel. And in goal for Neshaminy High School, number 17, Sean O'Hara. And now, the starting lineup for your Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds. On attack, number 9, Will McCann. On attack, number 42, Gavin McDonough. On attack, number 15, Sean McLoughlin. At midfield, number 20, Frank Britsch. At midfield, number 31, Dave Stolsteimer. At midfield, number 21, Max Rittenmeyer. On defense, number 24, C.J. Walker. On defense, number 2, Luke Slavin. On defense, number 36, Jack Gravener. And in goal for your Firebirds, number 11, Ryan Ford. The Firebirds are led by head coach Ryan Tessler and assistants Fran Cattani, Steve Keogh, Kyle McSpedon, and Mark Whartenby. Now please stand for the playing of our national anthem. One correction, starting on attack for the Firebirds, number 15. Number one, Jason Smaron. Again, Jason Smaron starts for the Firebirds on attack. Well, hello everyone, and welcome here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus of the Fran Nick Memorial Field for a great game of lacrosse between the Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds and Neshaminy High School, who visits Holy Ghost today. And this should be a fun, exciting one. Lacrosse, this is my first time, David Chapansky with you here commentating lacrosse. It should be an interesting one. Holy Ghost coming into this game with a record of 1-3. Their starting goaltender is Ryan Forde. He had a fantastic game the other day. Stopping many shots. I believe at the end of the game his number was close to 20. And for Neshaminy, it'll be number 17, Sean O'Hara. Firebirds right now are in the offensive zone of Neshaminy.
as Neshaminy will pick it up and we'll have a stoppage of play. So give me some time, pardon me some time to get everything correctly with lacrosse. Again, this is my first time doing lacrosse. My paper, my roster just blew away. Thank you, Mr. Asani, for picking that up for me. Here's Neshaminy attacking the Jarrett Edminster on attack for Neshaminy right now. Now, but going behind the net is Colin Heltzel, and he'll shoot, but he will be knocked down, and we'll have a stoppage of play once again here in front of the Holy Ghost Prep net. But of course, it's manned by Ryan Forde, and we'll talk about him a lot today. As I said, he had a great game the other day, and we'll really dive into his performance. Holy Ghost did lose the other day to Council Rock North. Final score of 12-2, I believe, that day. I'll double check that in just a little bit. I was doing the PA announcing for lacrosse for most of it, so we'll try some commentating on the live stream. With 9 minutes and 20 seconds left here in quarter number one. It is a windy day for some lacrosse. As looks like the referees are trying to decide where the face-off will be. And they're going to continue to try to decide this. So in the meantime, talk about the Holy Ghost Prep starting lineup. On attack number 9, Will McCann. On attack number 42, Gavin McDonough. On attack number, they changed that actually, did the Firebirds. It's number 1. I'll try to get a name. I believe it's Jason, but for some reason I'm blanking on his last name. Sean McLoughlin comes out, though, for the Firebirds on attack. At midfield number 20, Frank Britsch. At midfield number 31, Dave Stolsteimer. At midfield number 21, Max Rittenmeyer. On defense number 24, CJ Walker. On defense number 2, Luke Slavin. And on defense number 36, Jack Grabner for Ryan Forde, who's in the net for the Firebirds. I'll use my lanyard given to me by Mr. Whartenby, one of our coaches for lacrosse, and it's Jason Smaron who gets the start for the Firebirds in place of Sean McLoughlin. So right now, Holy Ghost Prep in control of the ball, and they're going to get set up here in their offensive zone. Now Max Rittenmeyer in control. Now back out to Dave Stolsteimer, who will now look to set up here and try to score on Neshaminy. That's Dave who moves in. Stolsteimer comes in towards the net, his shot, and he scores. Dave Stolsteimer scores the first goal of the day for the Firebirds, first goal of the game on a beautiful shot. The assist by Max Rittenmeyer, who had a great game the other day, scoring 2 goals against Council Rock North. And the Firebirds have a 1-0 lead. Dave just approaching the net fast there and gets past the goaltender, Sean O'Hara. So 1-0 Firebirds with 8 minutes and 33 seconds left to go here in quarter number one. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel for great athletics and also academic and just keeping up with what's going on campus. I have to make sure that I don't lose my papers today. You're in the wind any more than what I already did. So face off back at center. Frank Britsch out there for the Firebirds. He has been a face-off machine. That's his best asset and really helps the Firebirds win some face-offs. He does lose the draw, though, here to Neshaminy. And taking it up is Liam Moss. Liam Moss drives towards Forde. He shoots, and it's blocked. Good piece there by the Firebirds. That was picked up by CJ Walker, who got the piece of it. Now the Firebirds taking it the other way. Forde shoots it down the other end. Now it's picked up by Neshaminy. And now Neshaminy has it. In control of Bobby Blum, the defenseman, who now passes it towards midfield, and now Neshaminy is coming on attack here against the Firebirds. Lining up, passing it underneath the net is Neshaminy, and they score. It was a pass in front of the net. The assist goes number 15, Ethan Rooney, and looks like putting that one in the back of the net is Colin Heltzel, who scores to tie this game up at 1 apiece with 7 minutes and 53 seconds left here in quarter number one. So the Firebirds got the first goal of the day, but within 45 seconds later, Neshaminy evens it up, I believe, again, once again, the goal scored by Colin Heltzel, who ties this game up for Neshaminy. Holy Ghost Prep just never had control of the ball there off of the faceoff. Winning the faceoff was Moss, who got it quickly downfield to score on Ryan Forde and the Firebirds. So now faceoff is won, and we'll not have a stoppage. Again, give me some time. Still trying to get used to lacrosse. First one commentating it. And now Holy Ghost Prep sets up. Max Rittenmeyer gives it underneath to Will McCann. Now gives it underneath the net. Holy Ghost now once again trying to get set up. Back out to Dave Stolsteimer, who scored the first goal of the day for the Firebirds just about a minute ago. Now it's in control of Max Rittenmeyer. Max now drives, passes underneath, and it's tipped by Bobby Blum. And now Neshaminy takes it the other way. It's Blum who has it, being chased down by Dave Stolsteimer. Blum has it, once again trying to be bodied and checked out of bounds, but now Holy Ghost Prep comes up with it, and the Firebirds are surging the other way. That's Luke Slavin. Luke has it, pass it to Will McCann underneath, and his shot is tipped by O'Hara and Sade. Firebirds get it back, though, behind the net. That's Gavin McDonough, who now gets it back out, and it's lost after it was fumbled by Gavin McDonough. Now it's picked up, and going the other way is Neshaminy. That's Logan Backhaus, who's driving for Neshaminy towards the net. He fakes a shot, passes underneath. Now once again, another pass underneath. In front towards Forde, it's blocked by a Firebird, and it goes out towards midfield. We're picking it up there is, that might have been Logan Hood. But anyway, it's now in the hands of Pat Courtney, who now gives it off to Lucas Mayer, who now drives, being heavily guarded by the Firebirds, passes it back out to Rooney. Rooney, his shot is going to go past Ryan Forde in the net of the Firebirds, and it will go out of play. We have 6 minutes and 24 seconds left here in quarter number one. 1-1 game. If you're just joining us, Firebirds' first goal scored by Dave Stolsteimer about 2 minutes ago. So now Neshaminy will inbound it here. Liam Mayer now passes it back out to Ethan Rooney, who now gets set up. Rooney being guarded. Now Rooney, the shot was tipped and it's stolen by the Firebirds. Going the other way is, I believe that's Max. Max now gives it to Will McCann. McCann sets up, throws it underneath. The pass is picked up and scored. And scoring the goal for the Firebirds is the freshman, number one, Jason Samarin, who gets the start for Sean McLoughlin. And the Firebirds take the lead 2-1. So the freshman Samarin makes some noise here on attack, and a beautiful pass there by Max to get it to Will McCann, who gets it underneath and picked up by Samarin to score. Firebirds take a 2-1 lead with 5 minutes and 59 seconds left here in quarter number one. Pretty good crowd on set today on this cloudy Monday afternoon. Faceoff once again at center. Very cloudy and windy. Faceoff was won by the Firebirds. It's picked up by Frankie Britsch, who now still has it, I believe. He does, and now Britsch will try to get the Firebirds set up here. Now Britsch now gives it off to Dave Stolsteimer, who will now try to go to work for the Firebirds. First goal of the day was scored by Dave just about 3 minutes ago. Clock ticking towards 5 minutes and a half left here in the first quarter. 2-1 lead for the Firebirds against the Neshaminy High School. Dave has it, and he gives it off. Firebirds trying to once again get set up more here in the zone. They've been passing around. That's Mudrick, who now gives it back to Dave Stolsteimer, who will try to change the Firebirds set up here. Dave still has it, just in front of midfield. Now Dave, it was tipped by a Neshaminy defenseman. Now Dave with speed picks up towards the net, but it was tipped and lost. And picking it up is Jarrett Edminster, who now once again loses it to a Firebird. Dave Stolsteimer is still battling for it. So is Colin Mudrick. And we'll have a stoppage of play. And possession will now become in Neshaminy's favor. So now Neshaminy gets it started up as they pass midfield. With the ball, 2-1 lead for the Firebirds of 4 minutes and 33 seconds left here in quarter number one. Right now controlling the ball is Aiden Demi. Demi the midfielder. Now passes it underneath. Now in the offensive zone is Neshaminy. It's given off but tipped behind the net by Luke Slavin. But it's picked up once again by Lucas Mayer for Neshaminy. Now Mayer passes it off. Trying to get set up underneath is Demi. Good defense right now by the Firebirds. Now Demi passes it off. Neshaminy trying to get set up in their zone. Papers are blowing around here with a 2-1 lead for the Firebirds. It's now given to Ethan Rooney, who has it, looking to do something with it, makes a swerve move around, and Rooney shots. What a save by Ryan Forde. Rooney was right up front and personal with Forde, but Forde says no. Will retain, though, with Neshaminy possession. Shot there was taken by Neshaminy, and it went out of play. So now it's picked up once again by Courtney. Courtney now has it, drives underneath, pass to Edminster. He was blocked by a Firebird defender, and the shot never did get to Forde. So good job by the Firebird's defense. Firebird's defense has been roughed up recently. They need to get more shots on goal, and so far they've done a pretty good job at that, as they have the early 2-1 advantage over Neshaminy. So now Neshaminy once again with the ball. Ball is in the hands of Demi. Demi now passes it off to Roscoe. Roscoe gives it off to Rickards. Now Rickards passes it underneath to Ames. Ames dropped it, but he picked it back up behind the net of the Firebirds and Forde. Now Ames drives, passes it, but it was tipped by a Firebird defender as Hemberger couldn't pick it up. So they'll have to go back to midfield, and offsides was Neshaminy. So we'll pick it up here in Firebird possession. Will McCann, who has the ball, fumbled it, but picked it back up. McCann now pushes it underneath the net. Firebirds trying to get set up here in their offensive zone. McCann passes it off to Gavin McDonough. McDonough driving, but was stopped there. Now McDonough passes it off. I believe that is Colin Mudrick. Mudrick gives it off to Aniloff. Aniloff now gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Max now tries to get it set up, the junior for the Firebirds. Gives it back off to Aniloff. Aniloff and Rittenmeyer now having a pass. Rittenmeyer gives it off to McCann, who fumbled it once again but was able to pick it up. Now Will trying to stay inbounds. He does. He'll give it back to Max. So now Will trying to get set up. They pass it back underneath the net to McDonough. McDonough now drives once again, comes on the right side of O'Hara. But McDonough is shut down there. Good defense by Neshaminy, and it's picked up by Tim Trapp, who now has it. The defenseman takes it. Now it's in the hands of Sean O'Hara, and Neshaminy will officially clear to midfield. Dogani now has it, but still being pressured by the Firebirds at midfield. Now picking it up is Roscoe. Roscoe drives. He has two Firebird defenders on him. Roscoe once again trying to get into the offensive zone. He's being stuck up there by Frankie Britsch, and Britsch now will continue to push Dogani, who is there on the play, and Roscoe, but it will stay Neshaminy ball. Good defense, though, by the Firebirds. It's picked up now by Ames. Ames has it running around in the offensive zone, being heavily pressured by Frankie Britsch. Now Neshaminy stays once again in the zone, trying to get a good shot here, but Firebirds are just pestering with defense. There is a flag now on the play. I would assume it is against the Firebirds, and it is. So the Firebirds will be a man down with 57 seconds left here in quarter number one. 2-1 lead for the Firebirds if just joining us, but they're going to go man down. Here we'll see who the call is against. They made the call, and I do not see a number yet. It may be against Frankie Britsch, who is heading to the sidelines. We'll see if that is the case. With me being the PA announcer for most of these games, now not me being there, I'm not exactly sure what the penalty is against, but the Firebirds, I believe, are down here. But then again, it may have just been a stoppage of play. Again, first time commentating lacrosse, we'll see. There was a flag, though, thrown on the play. Demi now has it. They throw it underneath. That's given to Courtney. Courtney behind Forde, trying to get in front of the net is McVeigh, but they pass it back out to Roscoe. Roscoe gives it off to Demi, where he is blocked. Good job by the Firebirds' defense. But now Neshaminy goes back into the offensive zone. They pass it underneath, and the shot is blocked by Ryan Forde. Good save. And a guy right there underneath the crease did Neshaminy, but Ryan Forde once again says no. Another stoppage of play, and the whistle will sound with 17.9 seconds left here in quarter number one. I'm David Szpanski with you here on this cloudy Monday afternoon. Firebirds lead this one 2-1 so far. Firebirds have possession. It's Max Rittenmeyer with speed, drives, and the ball goes in. It's Max Rittenmeyer who has his first of the day. So Dave and Max, good friends, and they've been out on this top line, if you would call it, for the Firebirds, and they score. Dave has one, and now Max gets one as well. Firebirds take a 3-1 lead. Max had a weird angle on that shot, was on the left side of O'Hara, and he just never saw it. And I don't really think the Neshaminy defense saw it as well. Firebirds now bump their advantage up to 2 over Neshaminy. With just 5 seconds left here, Firebirds have done a really good job with scoring at the end of quarters. They did it last game. They done it in the game before that to take a big lead over Shipley, which was eventually blown. But they've done a good job with responding at the end of a quarter, and it really shifts the momentum. And we'll see if the Firebirds can carry that throughout the rest of this first quarter, the 5 seconds, and of course throughout the rest of this half, and more importantly, the rest of this game. As taken down there was number 14, Jake Herb. But he is up, and the horn will sound, so that will do it for the first quarter of play here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus. Firebirds are holding a 3-1 lead after a goal scored by Dave Stolsteimer, and also a goal scored by Max Rittenmeyer, and the freshman also scored, and that was Smaron. Jason Smaron gets a third goal, so again, a goal by Max Rittenmeyer, a goal by Dave Stolsteimer, and a goal by the freshman Jason Smaron, who had a great goal as well. So the Firebirds take a 3-1 lead as we head to the second quarter. I'll be right back. Stay tuned for more Firebirds lacrosse action. Welcome back here as we're about to get set for the second quarter of action here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus. David Schpansky with you here. Firebirds lead this one 3-1. Nice 2-goal lead for the Firebirds as we get set for quarter number 2. Goals scored in that period for the Firebirds. One by Max Rittenmeyer, one by Dave Stolsteimer, and one by Jason Smaron to give the Firebirds their 3 goals so far, and also a goal scored by Neshaminy, who visits Holy Ghost on this Monday afternoon. 3-1 lead for the Firebirds as Frankie Britsch is once again out for the Firebirds to take the faceoff. So the faceoff is at center, and it is won by Frankie Britsch and the Firebirds. So Frankie has it, being pestered by Hetzel and Meehan of Neshaminy. But Frankie now working around the, trying to not go out of bounds. Britsch drives, was sealed off there by Meehan. Now Frankie drives, passes underneath, and shooting it just high was Mike Dombrowski. It will go out of play. Firebirds will keep it here with 11 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock here in quarter number 2, just underway for the second quarter. Firebirds have it. That's Smaron, who gives it to Max Rittenmeyer. Rittenmeyer gives it off to Aniloff. Aniloff passes it. Now gets it back. It was lost by Aniloff, so now they'll have to go back just a little bit with the Firebirds and regroup with a 3-1 lead here in the second quarter. Now Max has it, but dropped it. No pressure, though, coming from the Neshaminy as it will stay in their defensive zone. So now Max has time. Throws it underneath. Now pass back out to McDonough. McDonough swerves, being hardly pressured by Ames of Neshaminy. Back out to Aniloff. Aniloff has it. Just inbounds. Gives it back off to Dave Stolsteimer, who will reset. It's nice to see the Firebirds getting more offensive time, offensive zone time in this game. Stolsteimer drives with speed. Underneath, now goes behind O'Hara. In net for Neshaminy. Dave surveys the situation. Now comes underneath with the sweep and scores. Dave Stolsteimer, his second of the game, and the Firebirds take a 4-1 lead. Good shot there by Dave. He had a good amount of time there to go around the net and make the sweep, and he gets it past O'Hara for his second of the day. Fourth overall for the Firebirds. Good start there to keep the momentum in your favor. And Holy Ghost does just that coming out of that first quarter. 10 minutes and 30 seconds left here on the clock in the second quarter. Timeout called by Neshaminy. So that means we'll take a quick timeout here on the Holy Ghost Prep YouTube channel. We'll be right back for more. Don't forget to like and subscribe. 4-1 lead with 10 minutes and 30 seconds left in the second quarter of action. After that Neshaminy timeout, Firebirds will come out of it with a nice 4-1 lead, courtesy of two from Dave Stolsteimer, a goal from Max Rittenmeyer, and a goal from Jason Samarin for the Firebirds. Neshaminy scored one midway through the first quarter to make it a 4-1 game. So Holy Ghost is going to try to keep the momentum in their favor, something that they have struggled to do the past couple of games. They've scored early for the most part and have kept themselves in the game. But then once it comes the second quarter, and especially the second half, they have seemed to fall apart a little bit. So they'll need to stop that here today and keep the lead over in Neshaminy High School, who visits Holy Ghost Prep on this Monday afternoon. David Chapansky with you here on the other side of this timeout called by Neshaminy. Firebirds just waiting on Frankie to get in the faceoff circle. And we're ready for action with 10 minutes and 30 seconds left. 4-1 lead for the Firebirds here in quarter number two. Frankie is set. So are Neshaminy. Or so is Neshaminy, I should say, and we're ready. And the ball is dropped. Frankie with a clean pickup. Now Britsch runs in the offensive zone. Now circles the situation. Realizes he doesn't have any room for a shot there, and now circles back out. So Frankie has the ball with just about at midfield there. Max Rittenmeyer. Now we'll come onto the field for the Firebirds. Frankie hands it off to Max. Max and Dave, the duo coming back out. They've scored three goals together on this Monday afternoon. Max hands it off to Dave. Dave now will survey the situation with Edmister at his guard. Dave still trying to get the Firebirds into an offensive plan. He uses his speed like he did last time. Now Dave drives towards the net but is sealed off. Pass behind O'Hara, behind the net. Now Samarin has it. Trying to draw up a play is behind O'Hara, being heavily guarded by Ansel. Samarin has it. Nice move by Jason Samarin, who already has a goal today. Now it's in the hands of Dave Stolsteimer, who passes back out. Good job by the Firebirds to keep the ball and trying to take good shots. Now it's Colin Mudrick, who has it. He gives it off to Dave Stolsteimer, who will once again probably try to use his speed here to get towards O'Hara. Dave gets around Edmister. Gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer, who shoots and scores. Max Rittenmeyer, his second of the game, and the Firebirds, just like that, take a 5-1 lead. Dave Stolsteimer and Max Rittenmeyer exchanging the goals here early. It's like a goal-scoring contest for those two today. They both have two, and they give the Firebirds a 5-1 lead. With 9 minutes and 13 seconds left here in the second quarter, Max and Dave seem to be really on it so far here today. Also getting some help from Jason Smaron, who scored the fifth goal for the Firebirds. Neshaminy will look to respond. With a little bit more than 9 minutes left here in the first half. Face off once again at center after the goal. And it's won by the Firebirds and Colin Mudrick. Mudrick is pushed down, but it's picked up. Good recovery there by the Firebirds. Driving is Michael Holt. Holt shoots, but it's blocked in front. And picking up the block is Jake Herb. And now it is thrown out of bounds. Might have been tipped by a Firebird, as it does appear that it will be that way, because it looks like Neshaminy will have the ball to start after that stoppage. We'll see, though, to get clarification. I know that Holt shot there, but it was blocked in front by a Neshaminy defenseman. And we'll see who will control the puck coming out of the stoppage. And it will be Neshaminy, I believe, who will control it. It's unclear where they're going to start this puck here. And it is in the hands of Neshaminy. So taking it up is Roscoe for Neshaminy. Roscoe drives with speed, makes it past midfield. Roscoe continues to drive, now is into the offensive zone for Neshaminy. He's wide open. Now it's passed off. I believe that's McVeigh. That is not McVeigh. That is Mayer. Mayer now being guarded by Luke Slavin, a college lacrosse commit, who now gives it off to Rooney. Rooney going to work. Rooney now drives, once again trying to get free. Good defense by the Firebirds. Rooney still has it being chased by two Holy Ghost defensemen. Now once again in the hands of Mayer. Mayer does a swerve move around Slavin. Mayer is open in front of the net, but he's blocked by Slavin. Nice job for him to recover there. Now it's being taken up the other way by CJ Walker. CJ has a lot of room in front of him. He gives it off to McDonough. Gavin McDonough now passes it back behind the net in O'Hara. McDonough gets it back, going to work against the defense of Neshaminy. That's Bobby Blum, who's guarding McDonough. No room there for Gavin, so he passes it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Max now gives it off to Dave. Max and Dave both with two goals so far with 7 minutes and 40 seconds left here in quarter number two. Max swerves around the defense. It's Rooney for Neshaminy. Max now doesn't see any daylight through. He gives it off to Dave. Dave swerves around, three defenders on him. Dave shoots and scores. His third goal of the game, Dave Stolsteimer, puts the Firebirds up 6-1. Beautiful shot there, and what was most impressive about that shot and goal by Dave Stolsteimer was he was completely covered. There was three or four Neshaminy defensemen on him, and there was nothing that they could do right now. Dave Stolsteimer is on fire as he has his third of the game, and the Firebirds take a 6-1 lead. We'll call that a hat trick for Dave, who is three early here. Max with two, and Jason Samarin the other goal for the Firebirds as they lead it 6-1 over Neshaminy. Firebirds trying to get their second win on the young season. Face off once again at center. This time it is won by Neshaminy, but the Firebirds are quickly on it. However, Neshaminy should recover here, and they do. So Neshaminy picks it up. That's Bobby Blum, but he was being thrown down, picked up by McDonough. McDonough, though, couldn't control it. The team has to pick it up here eventually. There's a scrum of about six of them in there. Firebirds and Neshaminy battling for it. Still nobody has clear possession of it. And it is finally tipped there, I believe, by McDonough, but McDonough couldn't clearly get it either. So right now it's just a scrum towards the offensive zone of Neshaminy. And it is a stoppage of play. And Holy Ghost will control the ball here out of the stoppage. They'll try to score once again here, but they lead it 6-1 against the Neshaminy High School. If you're just joining us on this Monday afternoon, don't forget to like and subscribe. Sun beginning to come out here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus, the Fran Nick Memorial Field. Max Rittenmeyer surveys the scene, now drives with speed, jukes around the Neshaminy defenseman. Max now sets up, passes it back out to Dave. Good defense by Neshaminy. Back out to Max, and it's tipped. They're off the stick of, I believe, that was Mike Dombrowski. Firebirds and Neshaminy once again fighting for it in the corner to the left of Sean O'Hara, the goaltender for Neshaminy. Firebirds did get clear possession, but timeout was called by head coach Ryan Tessler and the Firebirds. So they will keep possession here, but they will call a timeout with 6 minutes and 13 seconds left here as the Firebirds have a 6-1 lead. We'll be right back Firebirds so far cruising against Neshaminy. Welcome back. Here is the Neshaminy Holy Ghost Prep facing off in a lacrosse battle, a Monday afternoon battle, if you will. Firebirds lead this one 6-1 as we get started after this timeout. Should be momentarily. 6 minutes and 13 seconds left here in quarter number two. David Chapansky with you here on the Holy Ghost Prep Hill, if you will. So far for the Firebirds, 2 goals scored by Max Rittenmeyer. 3 goals scored by Dave Stolsteimer and a goal scored by Jason Samarin. Neshaminy got one with about 8 minutes left in quarter number one. We're now in quarter number two. Firebirds get ready to come out of the timeout. They did call the timeout, and they will have possession coming out of this timeout. So far, it's been the Firebirds dominating here. They lost their last game against Council Rock North, but they've come out of this game very strong. I know that head coach Ryan Tessler was talking about how they need to get more offensive pressure on the defense. They struggled with that last game. In fact, the Firebirds, a majority of their shots were by Max Rittenmeyer. He had, I believe, 9 of them last game. Firebirds only had about a total of 18 shots on goal. The other team, Council Rock North, had 18 shots on goal in the first half. So they need to get more shots on goal, and they've done that so far. They've had a lot of offensive zone time. Coming out of the timeout, Dave Stolsteimer has it. Goes to work. Dave gets open and passes it, or shoots it, I should say, just high of Sean O'Hara, the goaltender for Neshaminy. So Firebirds, that's Jason Samarin behind the net. Samarin does not sweep. He decides to get it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Max gets a shot. Good save there by Sean O'Hara, who gets a save there off of the shot by the Firebirds. So now Neshaminy will take it the other way as O'Hara will give it off to Ansel. Ansel is now pushed out of bounds, and the Firebirds will take over possession. So the Firebirds will have possession as Max Rittenmeyer will give it in to Frankie Britsch. Britsch passes it to the left side. That's Will McCann, left side of Sean O'Hara. McCann now gives it off to midfield. I believe that is Dave Stolsteimer. Stolsteimer trying to once again survey the situation. He does have Gavin McDonough on his left if he needs. McDonough has been mainly working behind the net today. That is actually Anhaloff, not McDonough, my bad. Anhaloff gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Now they pass it behind the net to the Firebirds. Firebirds trying to get set up. Maybe they sweep here, try to score against O'Hara. Dave Stolsteimer has it. Shimmies around one Neshaminy defenseman, and the shot will go behind the net of Neshaminy. Out of play. Firebirds, though, will keep possession here with 4 minutes and 47 seconds left here in the second quarter. Now Max goes around one Neshaminy defenseman, but now is being guarded by another one. That is Blum, and a shot, and he scores. Max Rittenmeyer, his third of the game. Dave and him scoring goals left and right. They both have 3 in this one. Max was able to just get open enough. He was being double-teamed, but Neshaminy couldn't keep up. And Max Rittenmeyer makes this a 7-1 game. Good to see him and Dave. Offensive zone time that's been prolonged, I should say, offensive zone time. Really, since midway through the first when they scored that goal. Face off once again at center. After the goal scored by Max Rittenmeyer, his third. The faceoff will be won by Frankie. Frankie now will control it cleanly for the Firebirds, but his 2 defensemen on him. That's Courtney who is pressuring Britsch, but now Britsch runs with speed, being guarded by Backhaus. Britsch still surveying the situation. The Firebirds will change here as Dave Solsteimer is back out to pick it up. Dave being guarded by Dogani. McCann out there for the Firebirds, along with McDonough. Dave gives it back to his partner, Max Rittenmeyer. Now Max, once again back to Dave, just a little bit of pass with 3 minutes and 57 seconds left here in the second quarter. 7-1 lead for the Firebirds. Firebirds now pass it as they give it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Rittenmeyer has it, who gives it off to Dave Solsteimer. Solsteimer being guarded by a wall of Neshaminy defenseman. Max shoots, and good save there by Sean O'Hara, who comes up with the high shot by Max Rittenmeyer. So O'Hara will come out of his net, and he will give it off to the defenseman for Neshaminy, Bobby Blum. Blum now passes it towards midfield, but it was lost by Dogani. Firebirds on a chase for it, but Dogani will pick it up and stay onside. He will pass it, but it was picked up there as it was tipped by a Firebird midfielder. And now it's a scrum once again in the middle of the field for the ball. Neshaminy trying to get clear possession, and they do, as it's picked up by McVeigh. McVeigh now gives it off to Backhaus. Backhaus being heavily guarded, though, by a Firebird defenseman. And that defenseman is Jack Grabner. Grabner fighting for the ball, and it's picked up by Max Rittenmeyer. As it going the other way for the Firebirds, good pass there by Max. Out in front of the goal by McCann. He shoots, but it bounces in front of the crease of O'Hara, and it will bounce out of play. So with less than 3 minutes, 7-1 lead for the Firebirds here in quarter number two. Don't forget to like and subscribe for lacrosse action, baseball action, also other action academically. And just subscribe because there's going to be a bunch of things going on campus. Of course, following the social distancing and COVID-19 protocols. Firebirds now pass it into the defensive zone. And it's picked up by Luke Slavin. But Luke missed the puck. And the ball is now regained. Doing so many sports, you sometimes get confused of what is being used. It's picked up by Mayer, and there'll be a stoppage in play here with 2 minutes and 19 seconds left here. And timeout, I believe, has been called by Neshaminy. So while Neshaminy and Holy Ghost take a timeout, we'll also do the same here. Firebirds lead this one 7-1 with 2 minutes and 19 seconds left here in quarter number two. Stay tuned for more action. Welcome back here with 2 minutes and 19 seconds left. Firebirds lead this one 7-1. 2 minutes and 19 seconds left in the second quarter. Also the first half of action. We'll have a halftime report for you coming up at halftime. Firebirds lead this one 7-1. They've had it all their way here in this game so far against the Neshaminy High School as the ball is inbounded to Ryan Forde. And actually we are not yet in play there. Just passing it around where the Firebirds, as a timeout was called there, looks like we'll get set for action here in just a second. Referee has not yet blown his whistle, and there he does. And we get started. Neshaminy has the ball here right now in the hands of Lucas Mayer. Mayer drives, being guarded by Slavin, and it's picked up. And good job there by Luke Slavin and Malpezzi to surround the Neshaminy attackman. Now that's Slavin who gives the ball off. Slavin now back underneath, picked up there by Gavin McDonough. His shot is just wide of Sean O'Hara, the netminder for Neshaminy High School. David Chmansky with you here on this Monday afternoon. Holy Ghost prep now with the puck. Frankie Britsch has it, going to work here against the defenseman of Neshaminy. Britsch will now once again survey the situation. Firebirds will try to get a change here as they'll get some new legs on the field, as that's Max Rittenmeyer. Max has it. He now gives it off back underneath. That's Smaron. Smaron now passes it back out to Rittenmeyer. Rittenmeyer has it. Britsch now goes around his shot, and it goes just wide once again of Sean O'Hara. Out of play. Firebirds will keep possession here. So Firebirds still once again set up in their offensive zone. Max Rittenmeyer with the ball. Rittenmeyer has Britsch behind him. He passed it off, but it was tipped there by a Neshaminy defenseman. Now there's once again scrum in the field trying to get to the ball. It's picked up by Britsch. Britsch now has it for the Firebirds. Neshaminy did a good job to keep him, though, out of the offensive zone, and will make the Firebirds regroup here with less than a minute in period number two, quarter number two. Frankie Britsch has control of the ball right now. He passes it off. Now the Firebirds drive. Britsch has it, sweeps, goes around, pass in front of Gavin McDonough, and the pass is just off. I believe that may have hit McDonough, and the ball will go out of play, and the Firebirds will keep possession here with 33 seconds left here in the first half. So Jason Smaron will inbound the ball. Smaron gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer. Rittenmeyer shimmies around, and his shot is once again just wide of O'Hara. So Firebirds taking a lot of good shots here early, but have not yet found the net here as of recently. Firebirds have had some good puck, good ball possession. Don't know why I keep on saying puck. Timeout called, though, by the Firebirds. We have 26 seconds left here in the first half. 7-1 lead for the Firebirds. They've done a really good job in, one, creating offensive opportunities, but also, two, playing really good defense. They haven't allowed the open looks that they allowed the other day to Council Rock North, and that's a big reason of why they are having major success today. Got to call it what it is. It's major success right now over in Neshaminy. Firebirds trying to get their second win of the young season. Firebirds' next game, correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. Sonny, Thursday? Thursday, Firebirds will be back in action. The baseball game, which we talked about the last baseball broadcast, which I believe is on Friday, which is supposed to be against Devon Prep tomorrow, that game has been postponed and moved back once again. That was already rescheduled, and that was rescheduled for the second time. So Firebirds baseball, they'll go away for a little bit. I believe the next game will be 9 days or so from now, something like that in terms of Firebirds baseball. But lacrosse will have this week, and also this weekend and early next week. So you don't want to miss any action. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll have the halftime show for you. Also here, we'll recap some of the scoring for the Firebirds at halftime. Right now, though, we got to get through these 26 seconds here in the end of the first half between Holy Ghost and the visiting Neshaminy High School. David Chmansky with you here. Firebirds maintaining a nice lead over Neshaminy right now, 7-1. As the timeout has now ended, and the Firebirds will have possession with the ball. We have 26 seconds left here in the first half. Once again, just joining us, like and subscribe. I don't know if the comment section is on. It was on for baseball. I don't think it's on. It is on. So leave some comments. Let us know what you're thinking about this game. Cheer on your Firebirds, or maybe you're a Neshaminy fan. Cheer on Neshaminy, too. We'd love to see the positive, appropriate comments here on the YouTube channel. Firebirds will start with the ball. Coming out of the timeout will be Jason Smaron, who will inbound the ball. Looks like to Max Rittenmeyer. Dave Stolsteimer is also out there with Will McCann and Frankie Britsch. So Smaron has the ball, gives it off. It was tipped there, but it did get to Stolsteimer. Now Rittenmeyer sets up, back out to Stolsteimer. Both of those guys have 3 goals today. Frankie Britsch now sets it up. Will McCann, who passes it underneath to Gavin McDonough. McDonough may sweep here. No, he gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer for a shot, and just wide of Sean O'Hara. And with six, this should end it. McDonough has it, 3 seconds. Underneath to Max Rittenmeyer, has to shoot, but good tip there to stop the ball from getting to the net. Good job by Kieran Meehan, who will stop the ball from getting to Sean O'Hara. And that will do it. It's a good defensive play by Neshaminy to end the first half as the train horn sounds. And that will also kind of be like a sound to end the first half. 7-1, Firebirds lead. They've had success so far here in this one. Stay tuned for the halftime show. We have 10 minutes into the start of the second half. And in a couple minutes, we'll be back to talk about what has happened so far in this game between Neshaminy and Holy Ghosts. Stay tuned for much more action. It's halftime, 7-1, Firebirds lead. Well, hello everyone. Welcome back here to second half of action between the Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds and the visiting Neshaminy High School. Firebirds lead this one by a score of 7-1 as we get started for the second half. David Schmansky with you here. Goals scored in the first half, 3 by Max Rittenmeyer, 3 by Dave Stolsteimer, and 1 by Jason Samarin. Neshaminy scored their goal midway through the first quarter of action. They have not had much offensive zone, has Neshaminy, really since then. Firebirds trying to get their second win on the season. Neshaminy has played decent defense as of recently. The last 3 or 4 minutes were shut down of that second quarter, first half for both sides. Just want to give a shout out to everyone listening and watching from home. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We did see the comments here on the YouTube channel, and we appreciate all of the feedback. And we appreciate everyone watching today's Monday afternoon lacrosse game between the Firebirds and Neshaminy. Frankie Britsch, the face-off warrior, is once again out to take the face-off at center for the Firebirds. Let's see if he could win another one. Ball is about to be dropped. And the second half is officially underway. Frankie Britsch wins the faceoff. He drives with speed. His shot is just blocked by Sean O'Hara. The ball will go out of play. And the Firebirds will keep possession here as Samarin has the ball, drives. Samarin being guarded by two Neshaminy defensemen. Samarin gives it off to Will McCann. McCann has it. Now the Firebirds trying to get set up in their offensive zone. Max Rittenmeyer going to work. That's actually Dave Stolsteimer. Max is on the other side. Dave with a shimmy move. He drives towards the net, but he is stopped there, but he still has the ball. He was forced out of the crease area there by Neshaminy defenseman, but Dave still has the ball. He gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer, who now drives with speed. Max, though, is knocked down by a Neshaminy defenseman and picking it up for Neshaminy going the other way. That was Bobby Blum. Blum gives the ball off towards Liam Moss. Now it's a scrum once again for it as the Firebirds and Neshaminy are fighting. We'll see who comes out of it, who gets clear possession. It is Neshaminy who does have clear possession, as was Liam Moss, who still fights for it, but the Firebirds are still trying to go for it, and a stoppage of play will be called by the refs, and it will be going the other way, so the Firebirds will gain possession of it. So both teams couldn't get clear possession of it, but I believe they called maybe high contact there to the head area maybe. As the Firebirds pick it up. This is my first game commentating lacrosse. I saw my first game just watching lacrosse period last week. So still trying to get used to it. Been calling basketball, baseball, hockey. Will McCann has it behind the net as he gives it off to Samarin. Samarin gives it off to Dave Stolsteimer. Max Rittenmeyer also out there. Stolsteimer goes to work against Meehan. Stolsteimer drives, tries to get open. It's underneath to Will McCann. His shot and scores! Will McCann is first of the game, and the Firebirds lead this one 8-1. Less than 2 minutes in here, and Will McCann extends that Firebird lead to 7 goals. Nice pass there by Dave and Max, who sees Will on the left side of Sean O'Hara, the netminder for Neshaminy, and the Firebirds have an 8-1 lead. The refs are going to talk about this towards midfield. I don't know if they're talking about the goal or maybe a penalty or a timeout that was called somewhat near the play, but they're going to have a conversation. So we'll see if this goal stands or not. Now, what's weird about this is it appears that that's what this discussion is strictly about, and not just because that was the most recent play that happened, the goal by McCann, but it also seems that the way the players are looking on the field would also tell you that this is a bigger call than maybe just a timeout or something like that. So we'll see what they call it. There is a flag on the play, and just by the reaction, it looks like that goal will not count. We'll see, though, if we can get an official call here. And there is a technical foul. We're not exactly sure, though, on who this is on. Again, I am the usual PA announcer. So we'll see, with no PA announcer, because I'm not doing it, we're not exactly sure what's going on at the scorer's table. But we'll try to find out for you here over the next couple minutes. They have not yet taken the goal off of the scoreboard yet. So the goal is still on the scoreboard, the 8th goal, but they have not announced, well, they're not going to announce with no PA announcer, but they have not yet made a clear decision. Now, they are going to start this ball at midfield with the Firebirds defending here in the Neshaminy up position. So I would imagine that right now that goal is standing at 8-1 with Holy Ghost Prep having a foul on the play. So it looks like the Firebirds will just be down a man, but the Firebirds will get the goal. So something must happen after the play, I would guess. Now Neshaminy sets up in their offensive zone with the ball. It's Demi. Demi gives it off to Mayer. Mayer gives it back to Demi. Demi passes it underneath to Rooney, who swerves around a Firebird defenseman. Firebirds are a man down here. Pass it towards the crease. The shot, good save by Ryan Ford. It gets back, though, to number 16, Ethan Roscoe, who does get the shot off and scores. So Neshaminy will cut the deficit to 8-2. It was a good initial save there by Ryan Ford, but there was just not enough Holy Ghost Prep defenseman there to stop a wide open Ethan Roscoe from scoring there for Neshaminy. So faceoff will come once again at center, as it's now an 8-2 game. Firebirds trying to get their second win on the season. If this score holds, they will get that second win on the season, but they have to fight through it, as now both teams have scored a goal here fairly quickly. Not even 2 minutes and a half gone here in the start of the second half. Third quarter, David Szpanski with you here. Faceoff is won by maybe the Firebirds, but fighting for it is Frankie Britsch. And Frankie falls down, and there is a stoppage here. And it will go the other way, so the Firebirds will keep the ball here. It's Frankie who has it. He passes it, but it's a low pass there by Frankie. Gavin McDonough is over to pick it up. Gavin will do so, but he's way behind Sean O'Hara. He was almost pushed out of bounds there, was McDonough, but the Firebirds will keep it here. Firebirds have possession of the ball, trying to get set up in the offensive zone. They lead this one 8-2 to the Firebirds. Now it's Dave Stolsteimer, who already has 3 goals today. Dave sets up here and goes to work against Meehan. Dave drives with speed to the left of O'Hara, trying to find somebody underneath the crease. He does get the pass off to Gavin McDonough. Now the pass there goes. It was tipped by a Neshaminy defenseman, and it was picked up by Jacob Aniloff. Aniloff now has it, gives it off underneath to Smaron. Pass off towards the crease by Will McCann, and his shot, maybe just getting a piece of that, was O'Hara the netminder. But nonetheless, it does not find its way into the net, and it keeps this at a 6-goal game. Firebird still possession. It's Jason Smaron behind his own net. Smaron has it, gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer, the junior. Max going to work against Meehan. Max shimmies around Meehan. His shot is saved by Sean O'Hara. So O'Hara now will give it off to Dogani. Dogani now has it, going to work against Max Rittenmeyer. He gives it off closer towards the offensive zone. Now closer really towards midfield is Meehan. Meehan tried to get it underneath to McVeigh, but his pass was a little bit too wild, as Ryan Ford will pick it up, the netminder for the Firebirds. Firebirds are now driving the other way, trying to get in their offensive zone. Going to work right now for the Firebirds is Connor McGrogan. McGrogan has it. He gives it off to McCann. McCann now swerving, or shimmering around, I should say. McCann has it. Now he's being pushed back out close to the midfield by the defense of Neshaminy. Pass underneath, but nothing is there. No room really open for the Firebirds. Neshaminy tightening up their defense here in this third quarter. 7 minutes, 30 seconds left to play in the third. Holy Ghost leads 8-2. Driving is Frankie Britsch. Britsch has it, has some room open. He tries to pass towards the crease, but it goes over the head of Smaron and out of bounds. Chasing after was Aniloff, but it will not succeed for the Firebirds, and Neshaminy will take possession of the ball. Taking the ball up for Neshaminy appears to be Rooney. Rooney has a burst of speed, but he's quickly being met. Good defense there by the Firebirds. Rooney fighting for it. Neshaminy will keep it as Pat Courtney now takes it up. Courtney drives. Slavin will back off for the Firebirds. Courtney lost it, but he picks it back up. He's now behind Ryan Ford. Good job by the Firebirds to pester Courtney there. Firebirds still chasing after Courtney, but he still has it. He's pushed down behind the net, and there will be a stoppage of play with 6 minutes and 53 seconds left here in the third quarter. So the Firebirds will get the ball back. Firebirds have it. driving up, I believe, is either Slavin. It is Luke Slavin. Slavin now drives. He has Frankie Britsch. He will pass it to Britsch, but good defense by Neshaminy to keep him out of the offensive zone and crossing the line. Britsch gives it off. I believe that is Max Rittenmeyer. It is. Max now gives it off to Colin Mudrick. Mudrick surveys the scene for the Firebirds. He has Max to his right. He will get it to Max. Max now passes it off to the left side of O'Hara. Now they go underneath to the Firebirds. That's McDonough. McDonough now drives, still behind O'Hara. He tries to move to the right, trying to shimmy around the Neshaminy defender. Still has it is McDonough. McDonough now clears free and knocks down. McDonough wide open, gives it off to Max Rittenmeyer, but he's quickly met by his number 21 counterpart, Tim Trapp. And now Neshaminy battles for it, but there is a bunch of white jerseys there. Firebirds will pick it up. It's Frankie Britsch who has possession for the Firebirds. Britsch has it with just over 5 minutes left here in quarter number three. Britsch trying to get the Firebirds set up offensively. Firebirds lead this one 8-2. Three goals by Max Rittenmeyer, three goals by Dave Stolsteimer. Max gives it off to Frankie Britsch, who gives it off to Colin Mudrick. Mudrick goes to work here against Backhaus. Mudrick drives. He's quickly met by a Neshaminy defenseman, and Holy Ghost will still keep it up. It's a weak shot as it was tipped there. But that's not Will McCann, that is Jason Samarin, who is back behind the net of Sean O'Hara and Neshaminy, who will have it. He's going to work against Tim Ansel. Samarin gives it off now, back out, as Holy Ghost will once again try to get set up. Now Colin Mudrick has it for the Firebirds. Mudrick drives, trying to get around the two Neshaminy defensemen. Mudrick still has it with a burst of speed. Now he gives it off. Shot there was faked. It's off to Will McCann. His shot, good save by Sean O'Hara. Trying to pick it up was Mudrick, but he couldn't get it. Now Neshaminy goes the other way. Neshaminy trying to get closer in this game as they give it off to Ethan Roscoe. Roscoe already has one goal today for Neshaminy. Roscoe has it going to work against Frankie Britsch. Now the ball is in the hands of Ames as he'll now settle it down for Neshaminy. Roscoe now picks it up closer to midfield with 4 minutes and 23 seconds left here in quarter number three. Firebirds lead this one 8-2. Driving towards the net, the shot, good save by Forde. That was Demi who took the shot. Firebirds now have it as they'll drive towards Sean O'Hara and the Neshaminy net. Firebirds now, wild pass there by a defenseman, but the Firebirds will still keep it. Will McCann now forces it for the Firebirds. He's quickly met by hard contact there, and now Neshaminy should pick it up in midfield, and they will. Heltzel picks it up for Neshaminy, but it's quickly tipped there by a Firebird midfielder. But Neshaminy does keep possession as Mayer drives, being met by a Firebird midfielder once again, but getting around him is Mayer. Mayer now into the offensive zone for Neshaminy. Mayer passes it back out closer to midfield. Driving with it is Rooney. Rooney has a burst of speed. Good job there on defense by Frankie Britsch, but still has it is Rooney. Rooney now sets up, tries to slow down the pace for Neshaminy as they try to inch back into this one. Picking it up is Luke Slavin on the interception. Slavin now drives for the Firebirds. He gives it off, is now trying to make a run for the offensive zone, is Jack Grabner. Grabner has it, has room on the other side towards McCann. He gets it off, but it's tipped by a Neshaminy defenseman in front by McDonough. His shot doesn't go. Grabner tries to shoot, and he scores. Jack Grabner gets the job done for the Firebirds, and they now lead this one 9-2. What a sequence there by the Firebirds. The voice is tired. Lots of movement in front of Sean O'Hara. He couldn't see it and get it clearly. So the Firebirds and Jack Grabner take advantage of that as Grabner scores to make this a 9-2 game. 3 minutes, 10 seconds left here in quarter number three. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the stream for great athletic content, baseball, lacrosse, but also academic content, and also just keeping up what's going on here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus. Face-off once again at center. Holy Ghost taking on Neshaminy. So far, Holy Ghost with a good amount of success in this one. They lead this one 9-2. Face-off won by the Firebirds. It was quickly, though, picked up and fought for by a Neshaminy midfielder. And I believe that midfielder was Herb, but it's continued to be picked up by the Firebirds. However, Neshaminy still battles for it. Scrum on the field, being pushed down to the ground, and there is a flag on that play. Being pushed down was Michael Holt, the freshman, and we'll see what the flag, or who the flag will go against. It looks like it will be going against Neshaminy. Looks like that might be number 21, Tim Trapp. who'll be called for the penalty. We'll see, though, officially here in just a moment. And it will be Tim Trapp, who I believe will be called for the penalty. Again, so Tim Trapp, penalty will be against him, as Max Rittenmeyer will start with the ball for the Firebirds as they lead this one 9-2. Max gives it off to Will McCann. Smaron, the freshman, already has one goal today, surveys a scene behind his own net. In front, Max Rittenmeyer, his shot, and he scores! Max Rittenmeyer, his fourth of the day for Max, and he gives the Firebirds a 10-2 lead. Double digits for the Firebirds as Max puts that one in the back of the net. He's been on fire recently, had a ton of shots the other day against Council Rock North, and him and Dave Stolzheimer, along with the Firebirds defense, and of course, Jason Smaron. And another goal by Will McCann have really propelled the Firebirds to this big 10-2 lead. 2 minutes, 40 seconds left here in quarter number three. David Chapansky with you here. Face off once again at center. Firebirds have looked strong here, especially offensively. They've not spent much time in their defensive zone. Firebirds do win the faceoff, but Neshaminy quickly battles back as the Firebirds never got clear possession of it. However, the Firebirds pick it up. It's Frankie Britsch. Britsch drives. The shot is way over the head of Sean O'Hara. Shot there taking once again by Max Rittenmeyer. Firebirds will keep the ball here. Behind the net, that's Smaron. Smaron gives it out in front to Gavin McDonough, but it was tipped by a defenseman for Neshaminy. That defenseman is Liam Moss. He is quickly met there as he's knocked to the ground by two Firebirds attackman, but going the other way for Neshaminy was Tim Trapp. Trapp, who was called for the penalty. Firebirds had scored on that penalty. Here's Smaron once again, who drives. Smaron tries to get set up. The puck was not knocked down by Trapp, but Smaron regains. The freshman showing some strength here. Gavin McDonough gets past a Neshaminy defenseman, and now the Firebirds will look to set up here as they have clear possession of the ball. Frankie Britsch controls it in just about midfield. Good stick handling there by Frankie. Also attacking him there is Bobby Blum. Firebirds will look to get some fresh legs out here on the field as Frankie Britsch still controls things at the top for the Firebirds. Aniloff gives the ball off to Will McCann. McCann gives it back off to Aniloff with a minute and 26 seconds left here in quarter number three. Aniloff surveys the scene in front of the net. He tried to get to speed, but he was shut off there. Aniloff still trying to be battled here close towards the out-of-bounds side here. Aniloff being heavily pressured here, and a timeout has been called by the Firebirds. They kind of had to do that because looked like Aniloff was going to be hit out of bounds any second there. Good job on the pressure and defense there by the team of Ethan Roscoe as a goal for Neshaminy and Tim Trapp. So as the Firebirds will take a timeout, so will we, with 1 minute and 11 seconds left on the clock here in quarter number 3, 10-2 lead for the Firebirds. Stay tuned for more lacrosse action here on the Holy Ghost Prep YouTube channel. Welcome back here on the Holy Ghost Prep YouTube channel with a minute and 11 seconds left here on the clock here in quarter number three. Firebirds have had it all their way so far. They lead this one 10-2. Max Rittenmeyer and Dave Stolzheimer have been the two players of the game. Four goals scored by Max Rittenmeyer, three by Dave Stolzheimer. But Ryan Forde has had a really good game too. He put up a lot of saves last game against Council Rock North, even though it did ultimately end in a loss for the Firebirds, unfortunately. But Forde has once again done it again. The shot quality has not been great by Neshaminy, but he's done a good job in fighting off some tough shots, especially at the beginning of the second half. You would expect Neshaminy to come out of halftime with a burst of energy, and they did, but the Firebirds held them off, even though they did get one goal scored by Ethan Roscoe. That was the only goal scored in the second half by Neshaminy. They did get one midway through the first quarter to start the game. Firebirds have had it all their way so far as they look to be on their way to their second win of the season. They have an 8-goal lead, but you can never get too confident. Need to continue to play defense and continue to pressure Neshaminy here. Max Rittenmeyer, his big day with four goals, starts things for the Firebirds. He gives it off to Dave Stolzheimer, who has three goals today. Stolsteimer surveys the situation once again as he'll try to get the Firebirds set up. Firebirds are in no particular hurry here as time is on their side in this case. Dave has it, looks around. The defenseman for Neshaminy, Evan Fitch, going to work, still trying to body up Fitch, is Dave Stolsteimer. He does have Max. Dave does a nice move to get around him, but is met by another Neshaminy defenseman, and the ball is lost by Dave Stolsteimer. Good pressure there by Evan Fitch, who stays with Dave there. Fighting for it just in bounds is Dave and Fitch, and now Neshaminy will get the more bodies there to help Fitch clear the ball to Dagani, but the Firebirds pick it back up, and now Neshaminy gets it after the Firebirds lost possession of it. Taking it the other way is crossing midfield now is Bobby Blum for Neshaminy. Blum gives the ball off to Courtney. Courtney now has it, surveys the scene for Neshaminy as they trail 10-2. Good move there by Courtney, who gets in front. Forde has it. Good save. He passes it all the way down the field to Gavin McDonough. McDonough is trying to fight for the ball, but that will do it. And the horn will sound at the end of three quarters. We've played three. Firebirds lead 10-2 over Neshaminy High School. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the stream. We'll be right back for fourth quarter action here on this what has now turned sunny Monday afternoon. Welcome back here. Firebirds lead this one 10-2 as we get ready for the start of the fourth quarter. Firebirds have dominated Neshaminy so far 10-2 as Firebirds have scored often and they've scored a lot here in this game. Firebirds on their way, what seems to be to their second win. Still have to finish out and play a full 12 minutes of lacrosse though. Max Rittenmeyer, Dave Stolsteimer, the two players of the game. Dave with three goals, Max with four. In this one so far, some help from the younger guys too. Jason Samarin, the freshman, doing a good job for the Firebirds. And that's really been a lot of the scoring. Good defense by the Firebirds and Ryan Forde. We talked to Ryan Tessler. Well, I talked to Ryan Tessler before the game today. His main thing was trying to get, and you could hear it from his, I was on the PA announcer for the past couple games, and you could hear it in his voice. He wanted more shots on goal. In fact, it got so bad last game for the Firebirds where there was not enough offensive zone time against Council Rock North that the players, even Ryan Ford, the netminder for the Firebirds, would come over to the scorers table and check to see how many shots they had because they couldn't recall the amount of shots they had. They weren't getting them often. This game has been the opposite. They've done a good job to keep Neshaminy in their own defensive zone, and they've controlled this game so far. It's been nice to see. It's been a fun game to watch as Frankie Britsch is out there to take the faceoff once again for the Firebirds. And the day itself has turned out to be a nice one. It's still very windy out here, not as windy as it was when we started the game at 3:45, but the clouds have cleared up. The threat of rain is off, and the sun is out shining here on the wonderful and beautiful Holy Ghost Prep campus here on the Fran Nick Memorial Field as we get ready for action here in the fourth quarter. Faceoff is won by Frankie Britsch and the Firebirds. Frankie, though, did lose it for a short period of time, picked up by Michael Holt. Holt drives into the offensive zone for the Firebirds. Holt now settle things down. Again, time is on the Firebirds' side here. Gavin McDonough has the ball, gives it back off to Frank Britsch. Looks like Firebirds will get some new legs out there. Britsch gives it off to Rittenmeyer. Again, time is on the Firebirds' side. Neshaminy has all the pressure on them here, down eight. Even, you know, they just want to score at least a couple goals here, at least a goal here to try to make a statement, if you will, even though the Firebirds have a good lead right now. Firebirds behind the net of Neshaminy and O'Hara. Just a catch right now for the Firebirds. Rittenmeyer Good ball handler, has it. Gives it off to McCann. McCann now once again gets the ball back. McDonough now gives the ball back underneath to Smaron. Smaron does a nice move. He drives towards the crease. Rittenmeyer with the shot, and he scores. Max Rittenmeyer, his fifth of the game, and it gives the Firebirds an 11-2 lead. And really, that is just doing the little things right there. They make good, solid passes. They get the ball to a good spot behind the net. Not much defense being played behind the net of O'Hara by Neshaminy. And Jason Smaron, who already has a goal today, the freshman, having a phenomenal game. He's able to get the ball towards the crease. Rittenmeyer there lines up for a great shot. He has a good righty shot and gets it just to the right side of O'Hara to sneak that goal past him. And the Firebirds now have an 11-2 lead. 10 minutes, 53 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Good job by the Firebirds to keep the pressure on here in the fourth quarter. Frankie Britsch gives it off to Michael Holt. Holt has the ball. He now gives it off to Brian Niemczak, who comes into the game for the first time today for the Firebirds. However, stop of possession, and Neshaminy will get back the ball. So Neshaminy now takes it the other way towards Ryan Forde. That's Luke Mayer. Mayer has it, being heavily guarded. Gives it off underneath the crease. Good job there by Luke Slavin, the college defensive lacrosse commit, to stop the threat there in front of the net. Good pass by Mayer underneath to try to score. Ball is in front. The shot is lined up by Neshaminy. Good block there, though, by Firebirds defenseman. Not quite getting it, though, are the Firebirds, but now they will pick up, and they should have clear possession, as now behind the net will be Ryan Forde. He'll come out of his own net, and he will give the ball off to C.J. Walker. Walker has it, now gives it off to Forde. Forde is out of his own net and will control it now for the Firebirds. As crossing midfield with less than 10 minutes left to go is Jack Grabner, who also has a goal today for the Firebirds. The senior defenseman goes to work. Grabner gives it off underneath to McCann. McCann is being forced out of the offensive zone for the Firebirds, but still has it. McCann trying to get the Firebirds set up here in the offensive zone. McCann drives towards the net, being guarded by a Neshaminy defenseman. Now McCann goes behind the net. That's where he likes to play. He's being guarded by Buckhouse. Play being called by Tessler in the Firebirds bench. McCann might try to sweep here. He now goes to the left of O'Hara. Passes out in front to Dombrowski, but it was tipped by a Neshaminy defenseman out in front, and Neshaminy is being, though, heavily fought, though, for this ball, as Neshaminy, though, will eventually get it to their netminder in Sean O'Hara, and he will look to clear it and get it up to midfield. O'Hara coming out of his crease, being pressured by McDonough. Gets it off to Bobby Blum. Blum shoots it up towards midfield, and it does get in the hands of Rooney, but he is being fought there by Firebirds midfielders. So now Neshaminy has the ball and will try to score here against Ryan Forde. Firebirds trying to hold them off. Driving is Mayer. Mayer's shot is blocked in front. Maybe Forde got a piece of that, as now Ansel has it for Neshaminy. Ansel being guarded heavily by C.J. Walker, and he will just toss it towards midfield as it got away from Ansel. Picking up in midfield is Mayer. With 8 minutes left here in this fourth quarter, Firebirds lead this one 11-2. Mayer drives. It's tipped there, though, by a Firebird defenseman out in front, but they cannot get it back. Good hit there, and the shot is lined up by Neshaminy and Roscoe, who already has a goal today, but it's offline. Going to pick it up was Courtney, but it goes out of bounds. Too little, too late for Neshaminy, as they couldn't exactly get to that ball there. And now Neshaminy will make a change, get some new legs out here on the field, some fresh legs. And Neshaminy controls it in their offensive zone. Ball is in the hands of Kieran Meehan. Meehan sets it up. There's a shot there. Good block by Ryan Forde, who takes it out of his own net and now goes the other way for the Firebirds. So there is an empty net for the time being, but Forde will get back as he does pass off towards Grabner. Grabner has it for the Firebirds, passes it by Dombrowski, but it was tipped there by Neshaminy, and now there's a scrum for it in the offensive zone for the Firebirds. It's picked up by Smaron. Smaron gives off to McDonough. McDonough makes a move. He drives. McDonough's shot, though, is sealed off by O'Hara and some Neshaminy defensemen. Good job by Neshaminy there with a little bit more than 7 minutes left here in this game. Max Rittenmeyer has it. He gives it off now to, it was eventually intercepted, my bad, by Neshaminy, and Demi has it going the other way for Neshaminy High School. So Nemi has it going for Neshaminy as they now are in their offensive zone and will look to get set up for Neshaminy. So they're in their offensive zone, trying to get something going as Neshaminy trails 11-2. Demi has it, surveys the scene in front of Forde, tries to shimmy around a defenseman. He does, but staying with him is Max Rittenmeyer. Did a good job at that, Max, with an amazing game today. Firebirds pick it up and now start running towards midfield. The ball is in the hands of Colin Mudrick. Mudrick is on his own with a lot of room. He gives it off, and the ball is slapped, but it hits the crease in front of O'Hara. Does not go out of play, though. Firebirds will keep. Firebirds now across the way to Frankie Britsch, being guarded by two Neshaminy defensemen. Good defense by Neshaminy. Clock hits 6 minutes and 20 seconds. Britsch is forced back out towards midfield and will now settle things down. Again, Holy Ghost Prep has all the time they need as they lead it 11-2. With 6 minutes left, Britsch now sets up, trying to get into the offensive zone of the Firebirds. A little bit of a bounce pass there. Over towards Mudrick. Mudrick drives, going to work against Dolgani. Now he loses it. Picked up the other way for Edmister. Edmister chucks this ball out of bounds, and head coach for the Firebirds, Ryan Tessler, will give it off, and the Firebirds will have possession of it with 5 minutes and 50 seconds. David Schmansky with you here. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the stream. Comment, support the Firebirds, support Neshaminy if you're watching us from Neshaminy, and tell us what you're thinking. We always appreciate any feedback. I saw a comment that somebody was asking Matt about JV games. No, only varsity games we do stream, but that is a very good question to ask. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We always like good questions to ask here on the channel. Max Rittenmeyer has the ball for Holy Ghost. He drives, passes it underneath the net, back out to Smaron. Samarin's shot goes just wide to the left of Sean O'Hara, and it will go out of play, but Holy Ghost will keep the ball here. JV team is warming up, as JV's game is next, correct? There we go. Max Rittenmeyer, pass off to Britsch. Britsch shot just misses, and O'Hara tries to win the race, but did he is the question, and he did not. So inbounding will be Gavin McDonough with 5 minutes left here in the game. That is not McDonough, that is Jack Grabner, my bad. Grabner gives it off towards Britsch. Britsch wanted a penalty there as he thought he was hit with the stick in the head, but he was not. So Britsch drives, goes to work here against Meehan, and there's some tripping going on in the field as a stoppage will be called. Meehan was on the ground. Britsch was upset there, and now some words are being exchanged as it looks like Meehan and Trapp were having to be pushed out of the way by some of their teammates as Britsch and Grabner were talking to them. So some words being exchanged here. With 4 minutes and 44 seconds left here in the game, Firebirds and Neshaminy will get some fresh legs here on the field as Neshaminy has the ball. Ball is in the hands of Brett Hemberger. Hemberger now gives it off behind him, back into the defensive zone. Firebirds had it, and a shot there was taken by Gavin McDonough, but it goes wide once again of Sean O'Hara. And with 4 minutes and 30 seconds left, another stoppage of play. And looks like O'Hara will go back to get the ball here as he'll inbound it for Neshaminy. Neshaminy off possession. 11-2 lead for the Firebirds. David Schmansky with you here on this Monday afternoon. Started out as cloudy and windy. It's now mainly sunny and windy, but still lots of clouds, but the sun has peaked out over the last half an hour or so. Neshaminy has the ball. Sean O'Hara, the netminder for Neshaminy High School, has the ball. He gives it up to Colin Hetzel. Hetzel is forced out of bounds. My bad, that is not Hetzel. That is Liam Moss, a 3 and 8. Look similar on those red jerseys, but the Firebirds will now have it as Moss is pushed out of bounds. So costly turnover there. As picking it up for the Firebirds is number 28. That is Connor McGrogan, but it was lost by McGrogan and picked up by Moss, and now it's a fight for it, as ultimately picking up is Pat Courtney, who has it. Now Courtney goes behind Forde and the Firebirds' net, as we'll try to set it up for Neshaminy, as they'll try to get some attackmen into the zone. Courtney now once again being heavily battled. Courtney, though, stays in. Courtney goes to work. And he did give it off to a short time to Ansel, but the Firebirds will pick it up. It's Colin Mudrick. Mudrick has the puck. He gives it off to Grabner. Grabner, the senior defenseman, now has it. He rushes towards his offensive zone. Grabner now breaks free of the defenseman. Grabner still free. His shot, though, bounces in front of O'Hara in the crease and will bounce out of bounds. Jack Grabner with a good play there to break free of a couple defensemen and use his speed to try to get to the net. Ultimately just missed the net there. Firebirds have it. It's Colin Mudrick, who has it being guarded by three Neshaminy defensemen. Mudrick now backs out towards midfield. Time is on the Firebirds side with 3 minutes left here. Firebirds lead 11-2 against Neshaminy High School. Now having possession of it is the Firebirds. Behind the net now is Gavin McDonough. McDonough has it. Surveys tries to get the pass towards the crease, but missed. It was almost picked up there by Malpezzi, but now taking it the other way for Neshaminy is Lucas Mayer. Mayer gives it off, and now a burst of speed for Logan Backhaus. Logan Backhaus drives towards the net, but then is pushed away. Good defense by the Firebirds and C.J. Walker. Now underneath, it tried to get the pass from Ansel to Edmister, but it was missed, but somehow the Neshaminy High School will pick it up, and Jack McVeigh will have it. Now back underneath the net to Courtney. Courtney surveys the situation. The shot there is taken, and it just missed as it hit the side of the net. The shot was taken by Jack McVeigh. And we'll have another stoppage of play with 2 minutes and 13 seconds left here in this one. Firebirds lead this one 11-2. Firebirds should hold on and get their second win of the season. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Next lacrosse game is on Thursday. The next stream overall on the channel will be on Thursday, as tomorrow's originally scheduled game against Devon Prep for baseball, varsity baseball, has been postponed to a later date. Firebirds lost their last game against Council Rock North, Firebirds lacrosse, but they've really showed some strength here in this one against Neshaminy. Neshaminy, though, does have the ball out of the stoppage. Aiden Demi controls it, gives underneath. The shot is taken and scoring for Neshaminy, I believe, is number 16. That is Ethan Roscoe, and that's his second of the game for Roscoe. So it's now an 11-3 game. Yeah, that was just a really weird sequence of plays for the Firebirds defense there. They were constantly chasing Courtney and Demi, and then it eventually was a stoppage of play, and I don't really think Ford ever saw that ball completely come out of the shots from Roscoe for his second of the game. Faceoff once again at center with a minute and 57 seconds left here in this one. Firebirds lead 11-3. Taking the faceoff for the Firebirds is Colin Mudrick, the sophomore. Mudrick now gets it up. Stay tuned after this game for a short post-game recap. Mudrick has the ball, and it's picked up by Neshaminy. Neshaminy now has it, but they're in close to midfield, and now Michael Holt will pick it up and just fling it in, as Neshaminy and Hemberger will have clear possession of it. So Hemberger gives the ball off to Bobby Blum. Blum surveys it and shoots it towards midfield. There was three white jerseys there, but it was picked up by Ethan Roscoe, who seems to be their star player of the day. Roscoe, with a burst of speed, drives towards the net. He now gives it off to Courtney, who surveys it and tries to get it in front in the crease, but couldn't get it there. It's a race for the ball, as it's picked up by Tim Ansel, but it was bobbled, and the Firebirds get it. Firebirds now take it going the other way in the offensive zone. Burst of speed for Luke Slavin. Slavin shot, and he scores. No, he does not. It went behind the net. It was picked up by O'Hara. Looked like he scored. My bad. No goal on Slavin there, as it looked like it was in the net, but it was on the side, and Sean O'Hara, the netminder for Neshaminy, picked it up. As Neshaminy now has the ball, and Holy Ghost Prep will pick it up. That's Michael Holt, but there will be a stoppage of play. We have 50 seconds left here. We'll take a quick 10-15 second break here. We'll be back. 11-3, Firebirds lead. Welcome back here. Timeout is called, so it was good to take the quick 15-second intermission there. Rest the voice a little bit. David Chpansky with you here on the hill at Holy Ghost Prep, just behind the bench of spectators, the rows of spectators here on the Holy Ghost Prep campus. It's really been a great day for lacrosse. It started out as a cloudy and windy day with a chance of rain. The rain held off, and the sun has now, for the most part, come out. Firebirds have also dominated Neshaminy today, 11-3. It's been a good day if you're a Firebirds fan. JV baseball is playing. Not quite sure what their score is. Varsity baseball next week. will be their next game, well, home game. And Lacrosse will have the next game for you on Thursday, Varsity Lacrosse. Firebirds seem to have this one wrapped up to get their second win on the season for Firebird Lacrosse against the Neshaminy High School. Firebirds 11-3 lead. The stars of the game, Dave Stolzheimer, Max Rittenmeyer. We'll talk about them shortly in the post-game show. The quick recap after today's game. 49 seconds left here in this one. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel for great academic content to keep up what's going on with the school. And also athletic content, baseball, lacrosse, and other sports. We streamed basketball throughout the winter season, and we'll continue to stream our sports games here for the Firebirds faithful at home. So if you can't make it to the game in time, work, or just COVID or different other reasons, we do appreciate all of you watching us here on the YouTube channel. 49 seconds left here. Firebirds will be in their defensive zone as Neshaminy will hold the ball here. Lucas Mayer gets set up here. Luke going to work against C.J. Walker. Mayer drives towards the right of Forde. Mayer shoots, but good save by Ryan Forde, who keeps the stick up high. No rush for Forde as the clock is about to tick to 30 seconds. Left here, Forde is very good at passing. We'll see if he can do that here. He's going to work against Pat Courtney. So Forde comes out of his net and gives the ball off to Luke Slavin. So Luke Slavin now has it with a burst of speed in the offensive zone for the Firebirds. Slavin gives it off underneath to Gavin McDonough. Good save by Sean O'Hara. And the Neshaminy defense will pick it up, being heavily guarded, though, by Gavin McDonough, as McDonough fought to keep that ball in, and he does. Macan now fighting for it. Now it's a scrum in the middle of the field to try to get to it. But the Neshaminy High School will ultimately pick it up. And that will do it for this one as the Firebirds defeat Neshaminy by a final score of 11-3. Stay tuned. In about 30 seconds, we'll be back for a quick post-game recap. Stay tuned. Firebirds win this one 11-3. Well, welcome back here. David Chapansky with you here on the quick post-game recap. Firebirds win this one 11-3 over Neshaminy High School. And the three stars of the game for you for the Firebirds. First star, in my opinion, has to be Max Rittenmeyer. Five goals on the day for Max Rittenmeyer. Dave Stolzheimer, the second star of the game, with three goals. And Ryan Forde making a good amount of saves. None of the official tally, not the scorer's table, but he was really impressive today. There wasn't pressure on him late in the period and even early on in the second half when Neshaminy came out of the half with a burst of energy, a burst of speed. So it is good to see Ryan Forde and the Firebirds respond and pick up their second win on the young season. Don't forget to like and subscribe as the Firebirds defeat Neshaminy by a final score of 11-3. Also, good game there by Jason Smaron, the freshman who gets a start for Sean McLoughlin, did a good job here today. And Will McCann, the sophomore, with another goal as well. The next lacrosse game for the Firebirds will be on Thursday, April 22nd. And that will be against Abington Senior High at 3:45. So Varsity Firebird lacrosse against Abington Senior High on Thursday, April 22nd. That's Earth Day. At 3:45. So again, this Thursday against Abington Senior High, we'll have Firebirds lacrosse for you, Varsity lacrosse once again. Stay tuned for the next game. We appreciate everyone coming out to the game today and also just listening at home. I'm David Chapansky with you. Firebirds win this one 11-3. Stay safe, and thank you all for watching. And for one last time today, go Firebirds.